bitch trying to bust my goddamn eardrums. What's Jesus. Up, what's up? It's your girl, Kirsten.
And Moni.
And we're back at it again on this Young Thirsty Thursday.
I was about to say we're back at it again on Tuesday, but it's definitely Thursday.
It's not Tuesday.
It's Thursday up in this bitch. It's not loud enough.
What do, baby?
I think you just like that snippet. So you just gonna play it as many times as you need to till you feel it in your soul.
I'm on a snippet roll today, so you might hear some random ones like.
Oh, God. Wait, do it again. What's that one?
DMX.
Ah, I was about to. What's the crump dance? Let me stop because I need to do better.
I didn't even know we had that one.
No, okay look, I had an individual crump battle in front of my vanity mirror.
Individual.
And I hurt my shoulder.
Who won?
Me, nigga. But my shoulder hurt. It hurt real bad. I think I'd like.
You gotta warm it up. You know, it's been quarantine, so it's like.
Yeah, I forgot how to twerk and everything. It's real bad. It's okay. We gonna get it together.
All right, y'all. So it's Thursday. We here with the trending topics, everything that's been going on in the news this week. So we about to get into that. We have a special guest joining us today. Woo!
Ooh, ooh!
Yeah, if you follow us and you saw, it's Chase Anthony from Vigor on BET. You want to introduce yourself and
BET
tell the people
Plus,
who you are.
BET to be Plus. Exact. And if you guys ain't watched the show, y'all suck because I've been telling y'all niggas to watch it months ago.
Right.
And that's that.
Months ago. She's been telling you months ago.
She told y'all months ago.
Oh, no. But Chase, what's popping? You want to introduce yourself to the people, to the listeners?
My name is Chase Anthony. You know, actor, comedian. You know, I got an entrepreneurial spirit. You know, we 80s babies. So, you know, we hustle a little different.
Mm-hmm. Well, you say you.
Yeah.
You say you what?
I mean.
What babies? 80s babies?
Yeah, we 80s babies. You were trying to do the math. You was like, hold on. This.
I was like,
if I carry the one. Like, how old is this nigga? Because he was
sick. I'm going to say 88.
88. I mean, listen, I'm going to take whatever you want to take. Because I'm feeling, oh, you know, you wake up, some shit hurt, you be like, damn, this age thing is real, man. They say it just come out of nowhere.
Honestly, if I lay, like, on my side leg too long, I got to, like, bend it manually. Like,
wow.
Ooh.
And you just joined the 30 Club.
30.
I still got time.
Every time I do something new, I'm like, this is 30. Like, I bought a plant. This is 30.
Bitch, that don't.
That part.
I bought a plant.
You put some on auto pay. Look, this is 30-year-old shit right
Dude,
here.
I
would never do this in my 20s. Auto pay?
Yeah.
Man. You just going to come out the same time?
You got
to
have
faith. Money the same time.
Yeah, anymore. I'm really hanging on to this last 29th year.
Oh, enjoy
it,
girl.
I'm not ready to be 30.
I think
why.
That you are.
Okay, well, you know, whatever you say. I'm not going to argue with you. I'm not in an argumentative mood today, mm-hmm. So I'm not going to debate you today.
But that's fine.
I'm not going to debate you today.
All right, so we at Thursday, okay? Before we get into our trending topics, I want to ask, what's one word to describe the theme of your week so far?
Oh, shit. One word to... Damn. Driven?
Okay. Do tell.
Bitch, why you always gotta have an explanation? Because I was just making up some shit to make it sound good.
Okay.
Okay, let me think for real. Okay.
Driven. You and your
actually,
grind.
No, it actually has been really driven. I have been being less lazy with, like, just
cooking
and putting stuff away when it needs to be put away instead of just, like, living out the laundry basket after I do the laundry. Mm. Cleaning the hair out the sink after I do my hair, like just the small things, you know, because that shit gets piled up real quick. And then just doing all this Never Not Extra stuff, you know, preparing for the shows and making sure we have everything that we need for the people. So, and then not being lazy at work, like actually doing what I'm supposed to be doing.
That's what's up.
When you work remotely, you can easily get lazy.
Oh my God. I gotta. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
My word is release. I feel like this week has been about release. I've been holding a lot in. It's been stuff like surfacing. But like the other day I called off work at like 2 and was like, I can't go to no more meetings. I need to deal with like whatever personal
life.
Shit. Yeah, I need to deal with actual real life things that matter. So that's been the theme of this week.
What about you, Chase? You celebrated a birthday on Tuesday. Yeah, hey, happy birthday again.
Thank you. I say my word would probably be reflective. I think, you know, every time you go into a new year, you just try to look at, you know, how you spent the last year and how you plan on spending, you know, your time going forward. So, you know, but I feel like this one was a little bit easier just because we've been sitting down, like we've been stuck in the house. So I feel like it's all been reflective. So
yes.
This one was just more so a little bit more peaceful of a birthday, because you ain't like this, oh my God, I ain't shit. I ain't did nothing with my life. What the fuck? Especially like when you ain't married with kids, like that's how your family and your friends make you feel. Like, what are you doing? You ain't ruined your life yet with a marriage and some kids?
And he tried to be like say that. It in there real smooth, too.
No, I'd be like that, because with me, like hitting 30, it was kind of like, it feels like that a little bit, but I know that that's not something that I'm ready for. So it's like,
I think it's different for men. I don't think a man should get married and have kids before the age of 35. In my personal 35? Opinion. 35? Yes.
So you think they should just date younger?
Yes. Older men should always date younger men. Not too young. I mean, younger women, but like, not too young, but you know what? But I feel like a man shouldn't get married or commit to anything and have children until he's 35. That's a topic for a whole nother day. That's just my personal opinion.
That is.
But okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anyway, y'all. So, continuing from what we talked about Tuesday, which was, you know, how it feels, especially right now, to be Black in, you know, majority white or only white spaces, or how, like, our jobs are dealing with the whole Black Lives Matter movement and how they responded to it. Mm-hmm. We invited Chase because it goes so well with the character that he plays on Bigger, which is Neon. So do you want to talk a little bit about like his challenges with, you know, kind of the duality of being fully Black and then also having to co-switch in, you know, certain environments?
I think for Deion's experience, as far as even when if I more so spoke on the similarities that I've experienced, just not as that character, but that background in accounting prior to playing that character, it is just those similarities. It is real. Like, mm-hmm. you're dealing with money. You're in a white world, supposedly, when you're dealing with all this money. And so it's hard, but in a lot of ways, as much as I think that it is that code switch, I don't think that a lot of us aren't really that free at work. So as much as, you know, you code switch, it's still just a level of you that's more articulate, a little less expressive, you know, a little less animated. And I think that that's just more so, as much as I want to say that that is that code switch, that's a white thing, I think that that actually is more of the formalities of just going to work and being at work. Yeah, it ain't absolutely. You ain't there to make friends. You ain't there to be cordial as much as you are to make money. And if that's what you think of a machine, It just you don't see those similarities sometimes when you do work in the environment where you're more comfortable. It is a little bit more expressive. You are expected to be a little bit more understanding to the circumstances. So as much as I've seen the code switch, I've seen definitely where the reality in, like, that's why it is sometimes that power struggle, because you don't get what I'm going through. You don't know what it was like. You don't know what it is. And then sometimes it is that other side of, like, well, this is your job, so do I give a fuck? You know? I think that as much as it's that code switch, I think that it is just more so you figuring out how to play where you're at. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You're like, all right, if I'm here and they speak in Chinese, then I'm going to speak Chinese. If I'm here and they speak in Spanish, then I'm going to speak Spanish. And I think that that's just the Black experience in America, not just at work.
Yeah.
That's, you know what I'm saying? That's everywhere. That's customer service. We all, so it's, I don't know. I think that it makes sense, but it don't, if that makes sense.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it does. Mm-hmm. It does. On Tuesday, we talked about our own personal, like, experiences with gentrification and working in corporate America. and how certain things that we do and don't like about being the only black person at work, things that we've had to deal with. And it's so funny because when Moni was rewatching the season of Bigger, she was just like, oh my God, like, I don't know what I would do if, like, one of my white friends is saying nigga, like, in front of me. Like, it's just,
it's
like,
happened
nothing.
Before.
Like,
it's happened before.
Yeah.
It at karaoke.
Nah,
no,
dog.
But you could tell he didn't like, you could tell that when he's alone, he says it. But he was, like, saying it under his breath, like, through the, he wasn't singing on karaoke, but he was saying it under his breath through the song, and I caught it. And I was just like, you know, but it's kind of hard because these people might be like up, like upper level than you, and it just makes it very awkward. But it's like, you got to think about how much do you respect yourself, how much do you respect your race to, like, just be stand idly by when something like that happens.
Nah, dog, I'm saying something, period. I'm gonna be like, yeah. I'm sorry, what'd you say? Because I just want to make sure.
Well,
I heard you
sometimes,
right.
Sometimes I think that it. I go back and forth on that, right? Because, you know, being a black man, like, one, you're expected to turn up, you know? And I think that that's always, it seems like the challenges that come with being black is that there's a black filter. You know, we got to filter ourselves before we're us in some sense. Mm-hmm. Uh-oh. And so I think that it, you're almost filtering all those experiences, so you got to filter it in order to be you. So you can't turn up like you want, and then it's not also on me to teach you. It's like, I'm not here to reparent you. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. So why am I here now going through this or getting myself worked up based on your ignorance? I can educate you if I see it fit, but other than that, like, come on, we adults. If you don't know what's going on in America and you got a cell phone, you don't know what's going on around you, you got a cell phone, you don't know what's going around you and you got black friends. So you can't say that you voiced the black experience. You could just say that it was easy for me to turn that shit off. Those are two totally different things.
Yeah.
So, like, I, as much as I say that I can't excuse it, like, okay, so now I beat your ass. What did we all learn here? So now we get into a fight. I get arrested. What did we learn here? Like, oh, he called me a nigga. Like,
Me personally, I've never been the type to, like, you know how some people are like, oh, I'm gonna tell the supervisor and make it like a whole big deal. I specifically, and I've had to do this, I go directly to the person. I'm like, hey, I can't tell you, like, you know, what to do personally, but in front of me, like, I don't want you saying
that's fair.
This. It makes me feel uncomfortable
that's
that
fair.
You feel comfortable to say it in front of me. And I've always been that way. I've never been the type to, like, go
I'm
to a manager or a supervisor, but I actually, like, will go to the person and speak to them. And then if you get mad about that, like, me personally coming to you, then that just means to me personally that you don't have respect for me. But, you know, I'm the type of person where I always speak my mind, and if you don't like it, you
see, for
kick
me,
rocks.
It's kind of like I'm already, like, a shy person that, like, is not really used to taking up a bunch of space. So it's like, I would have to work up courage to, like, have a conflict.
Yeah, and I don't nitpick at everything, but that I would be like, you know what? I'm uncomfortable that you did that, and I'm going to tell you directly. Mm-hmm. So you can't say that I didn't say nothing to you. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So that's just my thing. But, you know, I've had very interesting experiences working with others in the workspace, which is why I'm so happy that I get to work at home, because, ooh, child. Help me.
I thought it was.
But that's why sometimes. That's why sometimes I enjoy the fact that I also do comedy, because I'll beat you with wit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, so now it's not up for me. I'll give you something to think about when you're walking away. It's like, dang. So you just got stupid sperm all through your family. It's like, what?
Stupid.
It's like
sperm.
No, y'all just keep handing down this stupidity. It's like, I'll give you something to think about, because at that point, like, I might as well make myself laugh. You've been stupid for a long time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
You've been ignorant for a long time. If you have, I think that there's prejudices and I think that there's racism. I think those are two totally different things.
It is.
I think sometimes it's hard to not have your prejudices just culturally, your cultural biases, whatever it is. Racism is a totally different aspect. So it's like, you can't say that you comfortable. Oh, I should be comfortable saying nigga. It's like, no, but if you have black friends, then you shouldn't be comfortable saying nigga, and you're 30, so you should kind of know that.
Yeah.
So that's what makes me more inclined to beat your ass, because it's like, like, this is probably the only way that you're going to learn this.
Yeah. I think the only people I've given a pass is literally like people that I know that have literally from birth just only grew up around black people, and they like,
you can tell when it's like a natural.
I still feel uncomfortable, but it's just like, it's people that I know that have literally just been around black people all their life, like grew up around black people, their family is black, and they say, and they don't overuse it, but they say like casually, and it's just like, I'm semi bothered, but not to the full capacity.
But it doesn't, it's like when it's a white person, when it's like totally unnatural, and they say, it just, no.
I was about to say something, but I'm not, I'm going to be good today. Okay, so getting into, since Chase, you spoke about your role in Bigger and things like that, we definitely wanted to talk about some of the things that we mentioned on Tuesday as far as if we think things will be changing in the entertainment industry with all of these new stories that have come out. So first and foremost, I think just on, if my lip touches mic again, I'm going to scream.
Every week it does it.
I have Corona on my lip now, guaranteed. All right.
Knock on wood.
All right.
What you mean?
So look, I'm mad he raised his eyebrows at me. Like, so on Tuesday.
No, I'm not going to wood for you. I was trying to make sure this was real wood.
As the craze on, you know, I'm not on Twitter, but on Instagram, I've seen it too, the whole Nick Cannon situation. I definitely wanted to see what you guys thought about that.
To give people some background for those who may not have heard the clip. I listened to it, and he basically was saying, I don't know, I would have to listen to it again, because I thought he was just, like, talking about white people universally, but he was saying stuff specifically about Jews and, like, our melanin and how we have it and we're protected from the sun and they're not, and how they're barbaric and evil in nature, just really going in very... You know, mm-hmm. all of that.
And he was immediately
fired from
Viacom.
Yes.
Which basically owns every fucking thing.
Yeah.
I just want to know what your thoughts are on his specific comments. Chase, I don't know if you watched the video.
Can Chase comment?
I will say this. Technically, I'm on a Viacom network.
Right. That's what I was about to say. I just thought about that.
As much as I would love to speak on this matter, I think that, you know, to cover myself, I mean, I'm curious to hear what you guys say.
Oh, great. Awesome.
So for me, personally, I will say this. I just think that things should be the same all across the board. I just want, and not even just with the Nick Cannon situation, I just think that when a black person does something and a white person does the same thing, vice versa, I just think that the consequences should be the same. I just think that when it comes to a white person doing something, it takes a lot longer for them to lose their jobs, or there's more of like an investigation or things to talk about, or, you know, more things are brought to the forefront to come to defense for them. But in all honesty,
it takes full public pressure.
I don't agree with a lot of the things that Nick Cannon said. I get where he was going, but maybe he worded it wrong. I don't agree that people are born evil and that is in their nature. I feel like racism and things like that are taught to people. And then when it's taught, it's keeping up a certain culture of a specific race. But just like I don't like the fact that one of us can do something as a black woman or someone as a black man, one of us does something, now all of us are thugs or all of us are this way. It's like one of us do something, whether it's in the workplace or whatever, and it speaks for our whole race. And I don't think that that's fair for that to happen to other people either. Like when I've talked to you about, like, you know, different things where they say, oh, police this, police that. We're not talking about all police being racist or all, you know, this one community being racist, but we're talking about the specific police officers that are that way. Like I have white family members that work in the police force and they're not racist, but they have to worry about attacked that way because they're white in a blue uniform.
But the thing, this is going to be a whole tangent, but you know, like the new saying along with like Black Lives Matter is all cops are bastards, meaning that there's no such thing as good cops because you are a part of a system that is like inherently bad. It's like being a, I don't fucking know.
I get it, but think about people that join the police force because yes, they think because that they can make a difference.
Right, but and I'm like I'm with you on that, but a lot of people believe that like, well, you're part of a system that is bad and you're part of a system where if you speak up on when people do bad things, you get punished for it. So why would you want to be a cop?
I get it. And I think I think it's everybody's personal opinion. And that's why sometimes when you have strong personal opinions, it's probably best to shut the fuck up.
I feel like Nick Cannon is doing a lot. That's what I think. I saw a thread. I can't find it now, but it kind of like had my sentiments of it. Like, I'm pro-black and all of that. Some of the stuff I was like, goddamn, this is kind of like fucked up to say about, you know, another group, if it was specifically about Jewish people, but like another group that was like oppressed,
for a very small percentage of time,
but they were oppressed.
Okay,
yeah, we can't,
we still oppressed right now, but go ahead, what's your statement?
Okay, anyways. But yeah, I don't know, I feel like he kind of was he apologized on Twitter and stuff, or put out a statement, and he's just kind of like, I'm reflecting about, like, my words and stuff. And I really would like to know if that's coming from a genuine... We talked about this earlier. Like, if it's coming from a genuine place, or is it coming from pressure, or...
I think, honestly, he was just repeating a lot of whatever he's been reading. He's been very deep into trying to, like, know history and stuff like that. And I think he was trying to repeat a lot of what he thought he read. It's like when certain preachers preach the Bible to you, but they take bits and pieces and turn it into what they really want to say to you, but don't really teach it how to say it in the Bible. It's like that. I feel like that's what he did. Me personally, man. I could be wrong, but sorry to you, Nick Cannon. You know,
Revolt, Diddy over at Revolt said he could come on home. If you don't want the producers nasty.
Well, I'm sorry. I can't as a part of the black community, I cannot boycott Viacom. I know people were saying that, but
yeah, that's the question here.
BET Plus is my new best friend because they got all the black shit that I miss. I know. That don't come on TV
I just downloaded it on my Fire Stick now. So
yeah, I was like, nah, it's a no for me, dog. They've been getting my $10 a month already. So
side note, I found Girlfriends to stream. So for the next couple months, I'm finna be Maya and Joan and Tony and Leon.
Oh, shout out to Callie Scott, our girl Callie, who's Callie funny as fuck. Shout out to her. You need to follow her on YouTube for her Run Me the Meat series. It is fucking hilarious. Yes. Hi, Kelly girl. She said, I miss when he said about the Jewish people. And Michael said, what's up? Hi, guys. Thanks for joining, the chat.
And Devontae, thank you for joining.
Hi, Brody. Yeah. So, you know, that's it. That's all I'm going to say on that. Okay. Moving along.
What you got to say?
So, okay. Never mind. Go through this topic. I have a topic that I have to save, but we have to talk about it.
Okay. Got it. Yeah. I have a question.
I'm gonna write this out, don't forget.
I've watched Family Guy for a very long time. Also watched the Cleveland Show, and this whole time I did not know it was a white man playing Cleveland.
That's
playing
so Cleveland. Fucking racist.
Yeah. I'm sorry. It's not racist, but it's so like I feel like how they make him sound and some of the things he said on the show, I'm like, dog, I don't think somebody that's not black should have been saying that shit.
Yeah.
Chase, what do you think about him stepping down after 20 plus years of playing that character, and so he feels like a black character should play it?
I mean, to be honest, I think that it's animated, so it puts it in such a place of fictitious.
Yeah.
Like, it just, like, I understand it, but when you do voices, they call you in to do a voice, and they're like, boom, that's the voice that we're going for. As much as it's like, hey, we want you to play this black guy, and then you think that it's going to be successful for that many years, you're going in to play a character. So in a lot of ways, that's usually not the only character that you can play. You can play a variety of characters. You can do a lot of different voices. So as much as I see it from the point of view of why he stepped down, especially in this climate of saying, like, you know what, as much as I thought that I was okay because I was just going to work, I do see that, like, if I'm playing a black man, that a black man is available to play a black man. Like, why am I playing a black man? Like, what are y'all trying to say about this black voice? So I think it goes deeper as far as that. But him, I can't get mad at him for showing up necessarily and and not necessarily seeing the ignorance and saying, hey, I'm playing a black man on TV when there's a whole bunch of black men available to play a black man.
Yeah.
And then again, I think that even when we saw the other people that were stepping down from playing black voices and stuff like that, I can't get mad at them. I think that they were called in to do a job and they were like, hey, do you want to do this? And it's like, all right, cool. What characters are available? It's like, I mean, you play the black character and you're not thinking like, damn, did y'all call Taraji before you called me? You're like, hey, I've been
right.
at home. I need to work. So let me work.
Mm-hmm.
So it's different dynamics when it comes to that side as far as the artist. But do I think that there's some systemic oppression in the form of like, hey, we are the ones calling these people in for these jobs? But again, you're talking about somebody that's creating animation in the world. So if they're hearing a voice, as much as they're seeing a face, they're not seeing a face. They're hearing a voice based on a character that they see, that they manifested in their mind. Like, I think that's a blur line for me. Now, if they were in there doing blackface, I think that's totally different.
It is blurred because it's animated. It does remind me of, like, the fact that white people are getting these roles. It's just so weird that they get it over, like, somebody that's actually black. And it reminds me of this podcast I was listening to where, like, the minstrel shows, like, back in the day. Like, the blackface, when they dress up in blackface. Yeah. They were, you got something to say?
Oh.
The minstrel shows, like, back in the day, white people were getting booked, but they were not booking black people to actually be black people. So it's just so strange to me. Like, they would rather see a white person dressed up in blackface than an actual black person.
For
me,
personally, I just feel like it's redundant to step down at this point because it's almost like the Boondocks. It wasn't the same once they changed the cast and had different voices on the thing. It wasn't as funny. It wasn't like, you know. So now I've been watching Family Guy all these seasons. It's been 20 plus years. So now it's just like, I'm used to hearing this.
You get what I'm saying? I bet you somebody out there can do it.
It's like totally redundant. You've been playing it this long, so I get what he was trying to do.
Yeah,
but I just don't think that it's been this long already. Just do your job.
Like, you know what I mean? For accolades or what?
No, I think that at this point, because you know what, some people take silence as if they're for it,
but
but you have to understand and think about as soon as all of this stuff started, anything that anybody said that wasn't what we wanted to hear was a problem, even if they were saying something right. So I think that maybe some people just say, well, I'm gonna just shut the fuck up because, you know, I don't know, like, I don't feel that way. So, and that's a way to, it's like, I know I don't feel this way about a certain particular party or whatever, but maybe he thought he was doing the right thing. But I just feel like now it's not going to be as funny when Cleveland does something because you're used to hearing like that nasally country, you know, voice of him. And
I will say this. I will say this, though, right? We kept watching The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Oh, when like,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I'm just saying, like, as much as we get caught up that part, because again, now you could get somebody in there and they could be doing it better. You never know. But I understand what you're saying. It's like, listen, I know what we're going for, but in a lot of ways, he's playing a fictitious character just in the first place. All this is fantasy. So he's already been doing this job. So whether you turn Cleveland into a fucking bear, which they have on the show, you know what I'm saying? It's like, all right, well, like, how far are we going at? Like, we need a bear in here to play the fucking bear. It's like, oh, okay, cool. This makes sense. It's like, how far are we going to go with some of those things? Like, if you think about the cast of Madagascar, ain't nothing like it's, I understand it.
Yeah.
But it's like, we got to pick where we're going at. Black film, us playing us in movies, us seeing more of us in movies, that makes sense.
Yeah.
So now we're seeing more of our, what's the name? Now, if I got a nigga talking to a bear, I'm not pressed if I find out that it's like, hey, did you know that black man wasn't really talking to that bear? It's like, oh my God.
Okay.
So broken from this shit. Now, if I'm watching something and you're talking about The Shy and now I'm seeing the most gentrified version of The Shy, it's like, well, what the why am I watching this? And why am I not hearing my stories? Why am I not hearing my cousin's stories? Why am I not hearing about shit or seeing shit that I grew up seeing? Like, I've been there. I've experienced this. So that's why I say, like, you know, let old dude eat, man. Yeah. Let him do him. I get what he's doing, but it's to be honest, that's a noble cause. Like, I think that's the big thing that a lot of people should more so be aware of is, like, that there are people that are, the world has slowed down enough for them to necessarily move past whatever ignorance they were allowing to blind them. So them saying, like, damn, I didn't really know it was that bad. Yeah. You know what? My bad.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm rich as fuck already, but my bad.
Right.
I just feel like, man, there's bigger fish to fry.
That is true.
In my personal,
I didn't think
opinion.
Of it like that, because, like, the character from Family Guy that is in a wheelchair, it's like, are people that are in wheelchairs mad that the actor is not actually in a wheelchair? Yeah, yeah.
It's a gray area when it comes to the animation world, but I do think that there's now going to be an influx of, like, black film. I think that there's now they're more curious about our stories as much as. Mm-hmm. They've allowed it to be suppressed for so long. Now they're just like, damn, like, I know that y'all kind of, like, you heard it, but I thought that was just an excuse that, you know, Kirsten was calling in from work for, like, oh, you know, somebody got shot. It's like, listen, that happened last week, too. So, like, how many times? It's like, this is my experience. This is life. This is what's going on. I've been trying to let you know that this is what's going on. You thought that was just some excuses for me to fucking call in sick. Like, no, I could bring you newspaper clippings. I could bring you all that. That's the stuff that, like, we're going to start seeing. We're going to start seeing what real grit looks like in America. And that's what I'm hoping that, well, I actually can see it. You can see it starting to show up as far as, like, even on our show, as far as they talking about, like, real shit. Like, talk about our experiences. Talk about the shit that we're going to see in our 30s. Talk about the stuff that we failed to see in our 20s.
Yeah, that's true. I want to get
Which
in the
I'm
chat.
Super glad to see.
Yeah. We have Callie. She said, I agree. It's acting. I don't have an issue with animation as an actor. That's talent. Listen, if they offer me a Japanese woman and I sound, in quotations, how they want me to, I'm taking the job. Callie is funny.
Fine as hell.
Callie is funny as hell. But
as long as it's not like a, you know.
You're so sensitive.
No, because I just try to, like, understand other people, other races and their issues too. But, like,
if it's animation,
if it's like, if it's a Japanese woman just being Japanese and shit, but if it's like you are a different race playing a Japanese woman and you're perpetrating, like,
oh, you mean like in person,
if it's like racist, like this, like, is Apu from Simpsons, is it played by an Indian person? I don't know if they would take that role, actually.
No, he's not. I forget what the actor's name is, and he's been in everything, and he doesn't come off as this racist person. He comes off as somebody that he probably went in there that was like, hey, run down the characters that you want. He was like, all right, cool. So again, that's why I say prejudices exist, stereotypes exist. So they're like, hey, we need you to be somebody that works at a convenience store, and you happen to be Indian. You go based on your experiences there, and at no point is he necessarily saying something that is malicious. He's actually just working in the store. So he's not being racist at any point. He's not calling Bart Simpson this little yellow-white character. He's like, oh, no, get out of here. Oh, you shoplifted into the black character. Like, he's not even going in that realm of things. So it's like, I can't.
I feel like it's circumstantial, though, because I feel like maybe for Simpsons and shows like that, or like shows with humor, like The Office, where it's like it's racist on purpose for the purpose of, like, the show. I don't know. It's blowing my mind a little bit. I just honestly
sometimes feel bad for people that are in comedy, because I feel like people are so sensitive. Like, for instance, you remember Transformers? Well, I don't know. You don't fucking watch movies. Did you see the Transformers where they had the twin robots?
Never seen the Transformers movie.
Oh, yeah, I've seen it.
So all these black people were in an uproar because, oh, that's racist. I'm offended. They had the black characters with the gold teeth and da-da-da-da. And I'm like, so the fuck? It's comedy.
I try, because comedy. I'm on Twitter so much, so I start to feed into the like the wokeness, but I try to pull back from it and draw a line between like, am I looking for something to be offended by, or am I looking for something wrong?
And let me tell you something. This is why people always be like, oh, I don't like Kirsten because she ain't for the black people. No, I'm very pro-black, but I'm not
blindly.
Who said
you ain't for the black people?
You know, haters. They be mad because they don't like what I say on my show, but y'all don't have to listen. Now back to what I was
saying.
And that's on black. So like I was saying, I'm pro-black, but I'm not blindly pro-black. You get what I'm saying?
Point. Like, and that's my point with Nick Cannon.
Yeah.
So I'm not blindly pro-black.
A lot of people be like, oh, well, they black, but it's okay. No, the fuck is not. Like, every time you do something, it affects us too. Yeah. Like, you know, and I feel like we need to do better at holding ourselves and our people accountable and not being so offended at everything, knowing your battles, when to pick them, knowing when something is comedy and when something is actually racist
or
whatever.
It's sad for comedians.
Like, if you've ever watched Cloud 9 or, like you said, The Office and other shows that we watch, they say racist shit all the time, but the shit is fucking funny. Like, we know what, you get what I'm saying?
I'm thinking of the episode of The Office. Do you watch The Office?
I do.
When they put the race on their forehead.
Yes.
That was like the funniest fucking episode to me. But if people had that out of context, they would be like, oh, it's canceled, you know?
Yeah. The only thing I hate is how black people always die first in scary movies. Mm-hmm. But that's it.
Knowing in reality, we getting the fuck up out of
there. Yeah, we ain't investigating shit. It's a noise.
Hold on, this is what I will say. As somebody that's died in a scary movie, right?
Oh.
It was full of black people. It was full of black people in the movie. So
that's different.
Now, if I die at the beginning and it's a movie full of black people dying, then boom. Now, technically, that's why I say, like, it's relative. And granted, yes, we are the first ones to die in the movie because the rest of the shit that's about to happen in that movie does not make sense. So the bitch falling in the woods and all that other stuff is like this. First of all, this black woman's a track star because they all, like, it's just, they can't make it make sense in their head. Yeah. So that's why it comes off in that way. It's like, no, we've seen her. Yes, this actress is fucking fast as hell. She don't even know how to run slow. So why would you think that in a movie that she can't outrun Jason? This nigga is walking. Walking. The most intense part of him is the music. Like, we ain't never seen him pick up speed. That don't make sense with a black person because we're not going to stand there and be like, hey, what are you doing? We ain't never been that drunk. Molly, shrooms, none of that shit ain't never made us that curious to be like, oh my God, you have a blade. What are you doing with that mask on? Like, no,
right.
I'm gone.
Right. Nah.
Movie's over. This movie is over.
Yeah,
right. You're right.
Exactly.
I've always said
exactly
that. If you have that, the movie is. Yeah, I've always said
just
that.
Be like, shit.
I only have one last thing to say on it, and then you can talk about your tune topic. Do you want to talk about that first?
No.
Okay. So, Chase, do you foresee? You kind of spoke on it a little bit, but do you foresee? I know you said that you do think that black film is going to be a lot more. There's going to be more people more intrigued about that. Do you foresee? Black actors starting to get paid on the same level as their white counterparts, because I've been watching a lot of different interviews and stuff, mainly Viola Davis. She's been speaking a lot on that.
When people were saying that she's the black Meryl Streep, and it's like she's not getting Meryl Streep money and jobs.
Do you see there being like a change in that, or people in the entertainment world working towards making that better for black actors and actresses?
I think that there's no way to deny it at this point. You know, I think that at the end of the day, it only makes sense. Just like women getting paid, you know, the same amount. Like, it's why is this void? Because somebody decided it. You know what I'm saying? So now it doesn't make sense for it to not be equal. If it's going to be equal, then let it be equal. You know, it's now it's out in the open. I don't think that, like, at the end of the day, because the only thing that's going to happen now is Meryl Streep's going to say, I think that Viola Davis should be making the same amount. And Meryl Streep's about that life to the point where she's like this, hey, I called Viola and let her know how much I made. So she knows. So now you won't shortchange her on that shit. Just because, again, like, when you think about it, that's there are allies in this movement. There are
Absolutely.
Allies in progress, and I think that now when you think about women, like, especially like mothers, like sometimes like a sensible person, she's just like, nah, like I get your struggle. Like I've been in these rooms and these dudes have said certain stuff to me. So I could only imagine what they said to you. Fuck it. Let's get this bag.
Yeah.
What y'all say? Let's get this bag, sis.
No, that's what like, y'all say. I hate that. I absolutely hate that, that line, the get to the bag and the, what's the other thing?
Boss, but I mean, again,
but I bet I
get. Yeah, I'm gonna get to the bag, so I don't know what y'all talking about.
You're so ugly. I can't. What you got? My edges are sweating out.
Totally unrelated to our overall theme, but it is a trending topic nonetheless. Can we talk about Megan getting shot?
Can we talk about how Tori is the same height as this?
Okay, what was the thing? Because I didn't read that. Okay, so basically he's short.
Really care how short he is, but I don't know if Megan actually got
the
shot.
Talented
in the foot.
People
she was
are
wounded.
Always short.
It just says she was wounded in the foot.
She put out a message. She said that she got shot.
But how do we know Tori did it?
That's what people are saying. You say you're not short?
Yeah, I'm not short.
And you're talented.
I'm 6'1". Yeah, I was about to say I'm 6'1".
You a true 6'1", hey. Or are you 6'1"?
No, I'm 6'1" next to somebody else that's 6'1".
Okay.
No, because I get it. Men will lie about their height, and I get it. Like this, yeah, you understand them. This is like, listen, you're done growing, okay? You're 40. Let it go.
Damn.
It's over. The beard's not coming. The hair is gone.
That's depressing as hell. Imagine being a man that's short with no beard, and it's just not going to happen for you. You just got to have all the confidence in the world, and you can really make shit happen.
I'm just, in real life, I mean, you can't change anything. You might as well just go with it. Because there's somebody out there like this. Shit, that's my little man. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
I just put him in my purse and take him everywhere with me.
Never put him in your purse. What? He get on my nerves.
Put him in your purse. Come on, boo. Where we going?
And like the little pet bag. Yeah. You know how you get a little dog in a pet bag?
Yeah.
That's a good thing now.
What?
Short women men? Like short men.
I think it's something about that looks kind of cute. Like how Kevin Hart looks with Nico.
No, it's not cute. It's not cute.
It's like kind of like, I feel like it makes them look rich.
I will say this. I think every woman is beautiful, tall, short. So there is some beautiful tall ass women, just like there's some beautiful short ass women. And if I fell in love with a tall woman, then y'all would see her on my arms at every award show. Like this. My
so
you're
going to take them, however.
I love you, queen.
I, Kelly. Oh, okay. We have a listener in the chat that wants to know if you're single.
Yes, I am single.
Callie.
Oh, Callie.
He's single, girl. He said he's single.
It's quarantine. Y'all thought that if I wasn't single, first of all, if I had a girlfriend, it's quarantine, so she would have been here and she would have heard me talking to women, y'all laughing, she would have popped up in the back like if they laughed.
I want women to do better in that aspect. We really need to do better.
Listen, do you think that you can do better dating entertaining a man that travels every weekend?
Oh, absolutely not.
It's another one.
But here's the thing. It all depends. And I've said this several times on the show, and I've said it to you too, Money. It all depends on how that person makes you feel. It depends on what's going on between you and the person. That the man that you're with
that
has to make you feel
so
secure.
Good. That sounds so good. You still have friends. You still have some bitter bitches around you. You still got some hating ass niggas. You still have all these.
You still have IG girls.
You got IG. You gonna watch a show and something gonna give you a flashback or something. You can be sitting there and everything can be happy and something can come on Lifetime Network. Oprah can say something. Hell, you don't know how it's gonna come at you. Okay, it could be coming from the Red Table Talk. You never know where it's gonna come from.
Did we and talk about entanglement?
It's literally going to pop up, and then you're going to say him, and then now y'all both in some shit. Because either he don't know how to explain himself, he don't know
you
what
gotta
to say.
You got to be real solid. You got to be real solid.
I think it takes a strong person. I feel like to date a person in entertainment, you really have to... Me personally, when I was with my ex-fiance, like, it was like, yeah, he was always like, you know, he's with this celebrity, he's with that celebrity, he's doing all this other stuff. And it was like, for me, yes, he cheated on me. And yes, I eventually found out, but I always feel like when I'm supposed to find out, that's when I'm supposed to.
But he wasn't no mega famous.
But no, he wasn't mega famous. But I'm just saying he's still in the entertainment business. And he has his own record company and everything. So what I'm saying is, like, you're around these people. You're going to be around groupies and stuff like that. I had to deal with that.
That's a different level than, like, a top nigga that everybody wants.
I get it. But what I'm saying is just being around group. Like, he's just saying, like, having to travel places, be here, and this person doing that. Mm-hmm. You have to already be in a strong mind. You can't be a jealous person. You need to know that it's okay to have, you know, other friends and things like that. Now, if you feel like you can't trust that person, or if you're not in that space, then you shouldn't be in that space. But that depends on that. That depends on that particular woman. Now, if you know that he fucking around with all these bitches and he likes to fuck groupies in the first place, and you think that you can change him, because that's what women like to do. They think, oh, I can change him because I'm me. No. If he's telling you that he's this and this is what he want to do, don't try to change him. Either be there and try to hold your place, or go on about your life. But really? Don't get mad. Anyways, Kelly said she a 5'7", real average height. Let me give him a better experience.
She said 5'7", light eyes, thick thighs.
Kelly got some big ass titties. Lord have mercy.
Oh, wow, that got your attention.
Wow, he wasn't listening this whole time, but he heard titties.
He said, oh.
Oh, okay.
He is perked up. Like.
Yes, Kelly has big ass titties. Titties.
Hey, I don't. Okay, maybe Kelly's different, but people with big titties don't always like to be called out on their big titties.
I flirt with Kelly all the time.
Okay.
I talk about her titties and everything.
Yeah. I have boobs since I was like 9, so yes.
Yeah, Moni, she gets so mad when I, like, if I, like, say something about her titties or talk about it too much, she'd be like, Shayna, she'll call me later.
She makes me a little bit uncomfortable.
Shayna, you know what, Chris, I really didn't like that you were talking about my boobs.
Because I was really shy, and I have...
Okay, well, I'm sorry, Moni. I'll never talk about your boobs again. But I can talk about Kelly's.
But just like, you know.
Kelly said that we are real friends. Okay. Yes, we are real friends. I'm searching for a real friend.
What? All right, somebody ahead. That won't shoot me in the foot, like Tori did. Megan, do you like that transition?
No.
So what do you think happened?
I don't know, because Megan fight niggas.
You did like my transition, so don't lie.
Megan fight niggas, and I feel like she could just mush Tori because she like already talked.
Do she fight niggas?
Yeah, remember she went to jail for fighting her nigga. That's why she went to jail. Remember she was boxing him because he like cheated or had a baby on the way or something.
No.
Yeah, she was really young. This was before she was like on the charts. But yeah.
Anyway, that story's still unfolding. I'm interested. Some people were saying that Tory Lanez was busting on niggas that was busting on Megan, and that he was a real ride or die. But now they're saying like that he did it. So who knows?
Maybe all these Meg stories got shot in the foot on accident, because you know if you aim a gun at somebody.
No, you didn't read her. You didn't read her statement.
Okay, I'll read it.
She said, "I am in the hospital. They're removing a bullet from my foot. I'm in surgery because I was wounded because somebody shot me because they were trying to hurt me." That's what she said. Came from her. So, yeah.
But we don't know if Tori did it.
No, we don't know if Tori did it.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, hey.
But woo chow.
I guess.
What'd you say, Thaddeus?
It's...
He's 5'3", 120 pounds?
I think he's making that up. That's my goal weight. Huh? I think he's making up his height. And wait.
No, oh, he's really on the police report.
Oh, Tory Lanez is only 5'3". He your height? Wait, are you 5'3"? How tall are you?
Listen, it's not about me.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I'm 4'11". Right. So that's 5'3" is cool. 4'11", that's okay. A little.
Oh, 4'11", that's how tall.
And
that's
a half.
So cute.
And a half.
That's cute. Okay, well, now we got everybody's height. We got Chase height. We got
Chase 6'1". We got I'm 4'11".
Tori's height. We got Callie's height.
5'7", you 5'5", with brown eyes.
Aren't all of our eyes brown?
Okay.
Oh, that was supposed to be from a song, huh?
Yeah.
My bad.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Okay, well, it's plug time.
Plug time.
Chase.
Yeah.
Mr.
Yeah.
Chase Anthony.
Tell the people
what you're working on, where they can find you, all that great stuff.
I'm at Chase Comedy on all social networks. What I have coming up, we're still working on shooting season 2.
That's what's up.
I can go and binge that on BET Plus right now, Amazon, Apple TV. You can binge on all that stuff. Just writing jokes. Like, I also do comedy, so that's why you see that board back there with just jokes and life and all that stuff on it. So I'm excited to get back.
I like that.
The comedy, whenever that happens. I'm going to try to start posting more. I know that I don't post as much because, you know, sometimes I'm living life, so I can't stop and post to, you know, satisfy everybody else, I guess. But sometimes I need to participate. so I'm going to start participating a little bit more online. Mm-hmm. So you can check some stuff out there. And then, I got some other stuff that I'm working on as far as, like, clothing world, just because I'm a serial entrepreneur. So I think that outside of my main hustle, I think you need to do something else constructive, especially when you're single.
I'm about to put in the chat. He's single.
Some people wonder why you're single. Me, I like hustling. I like working. I like being creative. I like living in that space. So
that's why you're single.
Don't take it personal. Yeah, well, because again, like, they take it personal. Like, so you're just gonna choose that over me? Yeah. I mean, if it's a comedy show, if it's room for creativity for me, I'm gonna live in that space. Like Kirsten said, like, hey, I might as well enjoy this experience, because kids are going to show up and be like, so you're not going to come home and feed us? And it's like, I'm trying to be creative. That's not
good. Oh, yeah. So right now is a good time for you. Well, good for you. Entrepreneur with the Nipsey in the back.
You see me?
I feel like he just banged on the.
He did.
Real quick.
My bad. Nothing.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. If you could stay on just a little bit before we end our show. We want to thank everyone who tuned in today and who joined the chat. I'm sorry I didn't get to read everybody's comments. It was going too fast. But thank you so much for tuning in and for joining us. As you know, you can find us on Instagram at Never Not Extra. You can find me personally at Never Not Kirsten.
You can find me on Instagram and Twitter at Never Not Moni. And we're on Twitter at Never Not Extra. Spelled just like that.
Yes. And thank you to everyone that has been supporting our Extra Dollar Make Us Holla campaign.
Okay. keep them coming.
We're about to have some new merch soon. So we really appreciate you guys supporting us. I'm putting the Cash App in the chat again. And it's $ Never Not Extra, spelled just like that. Y'all should all know how to spell. Send us a dollar. We'll holla.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll have some new merch coming soon. And then because our my birthday live show / our 100th episode live show was canceled back in March, we will be doing that on Instagram Live as well as YouTube Live on July 31st, which is a Friday. We will still have all of the giveaways. So if you guys request to go live with us and participate, we will find a way to either mail it or drive.
I done forgot what the giveaways are, but they was good.
Yeah, we got hella giveaways. And then we still have gift cards as well. So we hope to see you guys there. Until then, continue to be extra.
Girls, wanna
a
wanna have fun.